What's up, my kings, queens, and trolls of YouTube? This is your girl, Queen C. Now, I had got cut off on my last Kodak Black video, and I had started to record it, and then I was like, finished recording, and then I was like, wait a minute, I'm gonna see what people's response is before I do my part two. So I gave it some time, and now I'm back because I want to talk about it some more. So anyway, I am so... I'm so surprised at how many dislikes I had for that video. It wasn't like an overwhelming amount. It was like 6. I think that's the most dislikes I've ever gotten for any of my videos. And you know, I can't see the faces behind the thumbs down. But to my people of color, if it was you that was thumb downing my video, that's cool. You have your opinion. But my thing is, are you thumbing it down because you feel as though it's innocent for a black male to state that he wants a red bone and not a black bitch, and you think that that's okay? Or are you just, you know, do you just hear that and just automatically assume that this girl, this woman, she's talking crazy, he can say what he wants, it has no effect, and this is... Because I'm trying to figure out if those of you that didn't like it, were you woke individuals, or were you the ones that are still sleeping and think that our words don't have any power when it comes to the black community? Either way, put it in the comments, because I really want to know, you know, what it is you guys are thinking. Now, I had a couple people saying, you know, oh, this brother, he's having a hard time. And then I had people say, you know, he's just stating his preference. Like, you know, it's just okay to state your preference. And I want to explain something to y'all. It goes beyond just stating your preference. You're putting something out in the airwaves at the same time you're dissing something else. You know what I'm saying? It's not like, you know, he just said, I want a red bone. He specifically said he wanted a red bone. He don't need no black bitch. Okay? So, you know, you can say what you want without being disrespectful to another group of people. When you go to the store and you go, or like to go get ice cream or something like that, if you go up to a person and they say, can I take your order, and you tell them you want a vanilla ice cream cone, you don't say, I want a vanilla ice cream cone. Don't give me no fucking chocolate ice cream cone. I don't need no fucking chocolate ice cream cone. I want vanilla. You don't do that. You just say, can I have a vanilla ice cream cone? So at the same time, if he's just practicing his freedom of wanting what he wants, then he would just say what it is that he wants without singling out another group of females. And at the end of the day, Kodak Black is a black man. He's a black man, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. He can get all the red bones that he wants, but when he gets any woman pregnant, he is, you know, it's possible, more than likely, it's highly likely, actually, that he will probably have a brown-skinned little girl if he has a daughter. So, if his daughter isn't a red bone, what message is he sending to his future self, his future daughter, about who she is? Because she's probably going to be a brown girl, and then she's going to be able to look back and reference the things that her father has said. And, you know, that's not building your black woman up. That's not building your black woman up. And I think that people forget we have a responsibility in our community to uplift one another. A lot of people don't want to do it. A lot of people don't want to participate in it because it's that mentality of every man and woman for themselves, when that's not how it goes. Because as one of my subscriber said, he's going through a lot. So what? Because he's going through a lot now, all of a sudden black people are supposed to support him? You know, we want our black support, but when it comes to respecting the black woman, you're not doing that. You're not doing that. Your mother is a black woman. And I made reference to that, and some of my subscribers told me I was creepy because he doesn't want to date his mom. And I'm like, come on, y'all. Why the hell would I say for him to talk to his mom in reference to dating his mom? What I was saying was, this isn't something new about this light-skinned, dark-skinned shit. This is not something new. It's not new for a black man to make it like a light-skinned woman is a trophy. It's nothing new. It's nothing new. And what you're doing is you're causing a divide between black women. Some of us know you just stupid, but then some of us are really like taking it in. Like, I've had friends who have, you know, liked, you know, men, and they would tell them that they were too dark for them. Like, what the hell? Like, why does that have to be spoken? You could say, you know, I'm interested in somebody, but why do you have to point out that a woman's complexion is something wrong with it for you. Why do we have to take that special time to do that? Why do we have to take that special time to say that a woman's complexion is right for them? We don't have to take time out to do that. You can like what you like I said, without offending somebody else. And like I said, it's nothing new. My mom has gone through things growing up being a light-skinned woman. She's had people assume that she was color struck, that she thought she was better than everybody else. She's had people tease her, tell her she was too light, tell her she couldn't be white, she couldn't be black, all these different things. My great-grandmom is a woman of a darker complexion. Now, her mother was Native American, light-skinned, with long hair, but her husband was a black man, so she had a brown daughter. She had a dark-skinned daughter, and my grandmom told me personally that I was going to have problems growing up as well as my mom, because there's this perception of light-skinned women just like there's this perception of dark-skinned women. And we need to cut that shit out, because like I constantly say, at the end of the day, they're not doing no paper bag test. And my suggestion was, as a black male, go speak to your mothers, because they have lived on this earth long enough to experience and know exactly what it is that I'm talking about. It goes deeper than just somebody sharing their preference. It goes deeper than that, because when you simply just mean to share your preference, then you say, I like vanilla ice cream, not fuck black ice cream or chocolate ice cream. You don't say that. You don't say, I like vanilla ice cream, fuck butter pecan ice cream. You know what I'm saying? So you go that extra mile to say these negative things about a group of people, especially women. We're sensitive, okay? We want to be loved. We want to feel beautiful. We have to start embracing each other. When you say negative things like that and you put that out there in the world, you can't get it back. It's out there. And then you want people to support you, and you want people to be quiet and just make it look like, oh, he's allowed to say, it's okay. He's allowed to say whatever the hell he wants. But when you experience the backlash of it, don't make it seem like people are crazy because they're speaking up about it. Stop participating in causing a divide within our community. Stop participating in self-hate. Stop trying to make it look like women, black women of all complexions, are either shallow or not valuable. Cut that shit the fuck out, because at the end of the day, when y'all out there looking for fucking support, where are y'all looking for y'all support at? Where are y'all looking for y'all support? Y'all looking at the black community for y'all support. So stop knocking people that are a part of the black community and thinking it's okay and it's cool and it's what's up to just be sitting there stating your preference and then downing another group of black people. Because that shit is whack as fuck and it's corny. It's corny as hell. And we need to wake up. Stop dismissing shit because you don't understand it. Learn something. Learn something. Learn about your history. Learn about the fact that this divide and this mentality was created to continue to separate us. Learn about that shit before you thumbs down my video. I don't care if you thumb it down or not, because it's more people that are woke and respecting what I'm saying than it is people not liking it. But like I said, before you sit up there and think it's something just as casual as stating a preference, look that shit up. Learn your history and learn something about your community. And instead of contributing to the negativity of it, try to contribute to the positivity of it. Okay? That's all I gotta say on Kodak Black. I'm about to look up some other stuff that somebody suggested to me. I just wanted to put this out there. Don't forget to subscribe to me, guys. 890 subscribers. I love you. I thank you so much. Follow me on Facebook at the Queen C's Hive, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat at Queen C. And peace until next time, guys.